Hey everybody, welcome to a new video. So Federico here, and today we talk about accessing an API with Max. I already made a video in the past on how to access an API in Max using Node.js, but since a patron of mine asked me about this precise API, which is about air quality, then I want to kind of doing this from scratch and show you actually a fast and easy method to do it. So this is the website where we can access this API on air quality and temperature, weather forecast, these sort of things, and we can access the data in real time. An API is an application programming interface. It's basically a way that websites and web applications offer us to access the data in their databases. So that's the website apcn.org/API. And so how do we access this data? Well, there is a very nice API documentation. So we go on the online API documentation. I say API, but actually I mean API, right? So that's only because I'm Italian and my English sucks. So that's how to use the API. It gives us a city feed. So we have to perform a GET request, which we can do with the Max URL object. And then we have to say feed, name of the city, and our token, because actually we need that token that grants basically that we are physical people and we are not misusing this API. So how do we get a token? Well, you just go here, token, string, your private API token, you click on this, let's see what it does. You put your email, you put your name, you confirm that you agree with the terms, and then you get an email, you confirm the email, and then it gives you a link that brings you to this page. I'm not even hiding my token, maybe I should, but who actually cares? So this is the page that shows us what kind of answer we get from this request. So we get a status, and then we get a data object full of the data we are looking for. So weather, temperature, mean, max, name of the city, all this kind of stuff. So this is the kind of request we have to perform. Here it says you can now try, for instance, to get the Beijing feed using this link. So I'm just getting this link, just copying it. This is my token. It will not work for you. I mean, if you copy my token, yeah, but I encourage you to create your own token. So I just copy that. I go on a new Max patch. I created the object Max URL. I create a message get followed by this link. And actually, I want to get a different data, not from Beijing, but from Berlin. So maybe I will just do like this. I will create a $1 and I will just input the name of the city I like to access here. And now let's see what we get out from the Max URL object. We should get actually a dictionary. So let's give it a try. Yeah, exactly. So we get a dictionary because Max interprets JSON data as dictionary, and that's exactly what we are getting out of Max URL. So let's just connect a dictionary to that. So a dict object, which is the way used in Max to represent a JSON syntax. So let's call it like my weather data or something like that. Reperform the GET request, double click on the dict, and you can see that this is the dictionary that we are getting. Now, all the stuff we are interested in is inside the body. Oh, and it doesn't seem to work. It gives an error. So maybe I'm sending the wrong GET request. Maybe it didn't work with the $1. Let's see. Yeah, exactly. It didn't work. The $1 is not being replaced by the name of the city. Okay. As if I didn't say that. Let's just write the name of the city manually, then you can find a smart way to do it dynamically, maybe with a sprint object. Let's actually do it with a sprint object. So we just create a sprint object, copy that, and instead of the name of the city, I will simply write percentage S. So let's see if now this works. Create a message box to see what we get, and now it works. Okay, cool. So let's just use that, sprint, get, Berlin, cool, click, we get the stuff, let's open it again, and cool. So exactly all the data we are interested in is inside the body. Now, the problem is that when we import these in Max, in a dictionary, it's actually backslashing all the stuff, which then makes it unusable as a dictionary on its own, because this is actually a JSON object of its own, is actually another dictionary, but actually is interpreted as a string. As you can see, it encapsulated inside those quote, which means it's now interpreted as a string. So we need to parse it from string to a JSON. So we're going to do that in JavaScript. So I'm gonna create a new JavaScript object and we call it weather parse.js, something like that. Double click, and I say auto watch dot equal to one because I want to actually use this file with Visual Studio Code. Save it on my desktop where this patch is. Now I double click on this object and magically it will open it automatically in Visual Studio Code because I set that it should always use an external editor. You can do that as well from your options in Max. Okay, so first of all, we need a reference to our dictionary that resides in the patch. So let's create a new variable, let's call it my dictionary, and let's create, this is going to be a new dict with the name, not my dict, but new dict, with as a name, the name of the dictionary we just created in the patch, so it contains the same data as that dictionary. Cool. Let's create a function which we will use to perform this parsing, so let's call it maybe parseDict. And let's write inside a new variable, which is going to be data. So this variable contains the data as a string. So let's maybe write this, data as string. And then this is actually myDict.get body. So we want to get the body part of this dictionary because, as we said before, all the stuff we are interested in is inside the body property of this object. So this is a JavaScript object and the body property of this object contains all the data as a string though. So once we get it as a string, then we need to parse it. So let's actually create a new dictionary because this is the dictionary in which we are going to parse this stuff. So let's create it and call it parsed dict, and this is new dict, and let's give it a name, so parsed dict, so we can access it also from the Max patch, and let's say parsed dict dot parse, so it's going to parse what data as a string, so we're going to parse the string into a JSON object, so basically a dictionary, and then let's output this dictionary from our outlet. So let's see if I manage outlet 0 parsed dict.name. So we actually just want to output the name of this dictionary. We don't really care actually about outputting the name because we anyway can access it from the patch by creating a new dict. Let's call it parsed dict. And let's activate this function which is called parse dict. So parse dict. And let's maybe use dict.view to see the content of this dictionary. So let's make a new call. Let's say parse dict. Let's output this dict. And then we got it. So that's now the data transformed into a JavaScript, into a JSON object. So basically we can access it using a dict inside Max. So let's say, for example, that now I want the city name, so I have to access the data city. So let's create this dictionary again somewhere else here, and let's say get data city. And from the second outlet, we should be able to get the name of the city. And now there's actually a dictionary of its own, because as you can see, it has a bunch of properties, so geo, name, and URL. So I want the name of the city, so I will write data city dot name, and then Berlin, Germany. Cool. Let's say that I want the forecast for the next day. So daily. And this is an array, as you can see, with 7 objects inside. So let's see how we can get that. So we're going to get data. Let's close stuff we're not interested in. So data, then forecast, then daily, and then O3, and then this is an array, so I want the first element of the array, so I will give it the name 0, and this is not over because this is an object of itself, so I want then the average temperature, so I'm just going to write avg, which is the first property of this object inside the array, so let's see, and then we get it. So average is 12. Cool. And as in the same way, I can access all the other properties of these elements of this array and all the properties of this JSON object, so of this dictionary. So this was it. Very easy, right? So hope this was clear, hope this was fun, and make good use of this power I've just gave you. I will release this patch on my Patreon for my patrons, so check it out. There's a lot of stuff there. And anyway, see you soon in the next video. Have fun and keep maxing. Ciao, ciao.